Good evening, everyone, and welcome inside the Troy Sports Center. Here we are tonight for Michigan High School Hockey High. Fred Nahan alongside Bill Jakovich. Tonight's game, Troy High School Colts versus the Royal Oak High School Ravens. And Billy, a big game tonight. Doesn't need any hype. It's a rubber match of a game played a couple of weeks ago. And so these players want to be on the ice just as much as we want to watch them play tonight.
They definitely do, Fred. It was December 21st, Saturday night before Christmas. Big lead by Royal Oak. They were up 5-0 with about 2 minutes gone in the second period. Troy High did not quit. They kept pecking away, and they scored 7 unanswered goals and took the game 7-5.
So Royal Oak wants to get a little bit of revenge to settle that score. Another theme running through this game tonight, Bill, so many of these players have come up through Youth of Hockey Associations here in southeastern Michigan. And of course, once we hit the ice, we'll recognize so many of these names and faces that you and I have watched play since they were very, very young. We are now going to our public address announcer.
And now, here are tonight's starting lineups, beginning with the visitors from Royal Oak High School. Starting on defense, number 3, Chris Schwartz. On defense, number 25, Matthew Boshi. Back forward, number 5, Kevin Trumbull. Back forward, number 8, Wade Herbert. And at forward, number 23, Evan Ball. Starting row, Royal Oak High School, number 29, Danny Harlack. Now the starting lineups for your 12 Colts. Starting on defense, number 5, Mitch Thompson. On defense, number 20, Jacob Smith. At forward, number 11, Ramon Camo. At forward, number 19, Jordan Sowerby. At forward, number 21, Pierce Baker. Playing goal, number 31, Michael Fisher. Head coach of Troy Colts, hockey squad, Tim Zimmer, with assistants Josh Murphy, Michael Peck, and Jake Murphy. Now our national anthem.
That was one of Troy High School's choral standouts, Meg Brokenshire, with the national anthem. Billy, the starting lineups have been announced. The teams are gathering amongst themselves, and we're just about ready to get this one underway. The Troy Colts versus the Royal Oak Ravens. It's going to be a good one.
It's going to be a great one, Freddie. Both lines starting power against power. We got Evan Fall starting for Royal Oak. He's their top scorer. We got Ramon Camo starting for Troy. He scores a lot of goals. We got both number one goalies in the net. I say all we got to do now is drop the puck and get this thing going.
Couldn't ask for anything else. Lots of these players, of course, as we mentioned early, Bill, familiar to one another, having grown up in youth hockey associations all across Southeast Michigan, and they are ready to drop the puck. Troy wins the draw. Smitty takes it over the red line, dumps it in. That's puck control tonight, Billy. That's going to be important.
You want to control the puck. Team that controls puck controls everything. You don't want to be chasing.
Smitty back after it. Is chased by the Royal Oak player back in the zone. Up on the half wall, here comes Ramon up over the blue line. He deeks and dunks over the blue line. He's going to get a shot. He throws it at the net just wide. Oh, and there's a big hit. Jordan Sowerby came flying in there. It looks like there's going to be a penalty, Bill.
There's definitely a penalty. I'm not sure who that's on just yet. Jordan Sowerby going for interference. So Royal Oak gets an early power play.
It's an early power play. Troy going on the penalty kill now. Looks like Babo and Alex Jakovich, Andrew Urban out there as well to defend a very early power play opportunity. This is key to stay out of the box tonight, Bill.
Well, you know, that's a problem that Troy team's been having the last few games. Way too many penalties, way too many penalty kills.
Troy clears it. Jake Howard up after it. Comes in over the line, and they dump it down the length of the ice where Evan Fall passes it cross ice. Back at the blue line, holds it up there, trying to get a cycle. Royal Oak back in. They throw it across the net. That steers clear all the way back in the corner. Royal Oak maintains possession, throws it at the net. Oh, and a big save, Bill. That's going to be key to keep that puck out of the net.
You want to keep the rebounds to a minimum. Royal Oak tried a backdoor play a little bit a while ago, and they just missed it. Got to keep your head on a swivel. Make sure you account for all the blue jerseys.
Well, those blue jerseys are still on the power play as he takes the puck around the zone, cycles it back to the point. Here comes a shot. No, low, behind the net. Andrew Urban chases there. Don't want to chase too much on the penalty kill, Billy. It's contain and control. Back to the point. Bashy takes a shot. Oh, the net almost cut, went through. Good. And now he shoots the length of the ice. Icing, well, of course, it's penalty kill, so no icing. Seconds left in the penalty Detroit, and one more time tries to clear the zone, not out, down once again, and this time they do get it back to center ice. Royal Oak cycles back. Ramon picks up the puck and he turns and dumps it in. Bester gives chase there. Oh, and a nice hit. Troy gets control. 2 seconds, one left in the penalty. Penalty is expired. They killed it off successfully, Bill.
Wow, that's a good job early on. You don't want to give Royal Oak any momentum at this juncture of the game. You want to try to steal some yourself.
Bill, the last time these two teams squared off, certainly a lot of personnel that are on the ice tonight, but some key people missing. Jordan Sowerby not on the ice for Troy that night, nor was Nick Bester.
No.
Matthew Bashy not for Royal Oak the previous game. He's back on the ice tonight.
Well, that just goes to show you it was a great game without those guys. I'm going to expect an even better one here tonight with them in the lineup. So plenty of talent on the ice.
Puck comes loose in the slot. That got a high stick, waved off. Mitch keeps it in. He throws the puck towards the net. Danny Harlick grabs it, and the faceoff will be just to the left to the Royal Oak goaltender.
I'll tell you what, Danny Harlick, he's been on this team since he's been a freshman. He's been a quality goalie all throughout his career. He's played on travel, started in Royal Oak House, and they're going to have to get some rebound goals or get some traffic, because if he sees it, he's going to stop it, Fred.
Campbell wins the draw, comes to the slot. Can't keep it in. Jakovich back after it. Alex Heap clears the puck to the neutral zone. Sauer just out of reach of Sauerby, but Ramon picks it up. He pulls up. He throws it at the net just wide. Up on the half wall, Royal Oak takes control. Just outside, dumped back in by the Troy Colts.
Not much flow right now, Fred. We're just kind of feeling one another out. We had the early power play for Royal Oak. Didn't amount to a goal. A couple shots by Troy. A couple of them went real high, so we got to get them lower, get some screens, see what happens.
Ramon Camo dumps it toward the net. Harlech grabs it. The faceoff will be just to his right in the Royal Oak zone. Looks like Howard is out there. Bobo's going to take the faceoff. Bob Urban, referee drops the puck. Stalemate, comes back to the defense. He throws it at the net, goes in the corner. Now Andrew Urban comes pinching in. The Royal Oak player grabs it there, but not out. Bobo knocks it back in all the way around the corner. Up to the half wall. Kept in and driven back to the opposite corner by Troy. Now Royal Oak gets it out, comes into the neutral zone. And it's banged back in. You're right, Billy. Just kind of feeling each other out like a couple of heavyweights. It looks like Coach Simmons has run the top two lines, at least for the first several minutes of this period.
Yep, we got a hand pass right there. It almost looked like a little pitch and catch there. Troy would get the puck, throw it in. Royal Oak gets it, throw it back out to Troy, you know? Like a baseball game almost.
Well, they are lining up to the left of the Troy goal, and as they do, we see Stunover to take the draw. Harry back on the ice, really a spirited player and a great member of this hockey team. Good to have him on the ice tonight.
Great to have him on the ice. Needed speed, because if you ever played hockey for me, you'll know one of my favorite things is speed kills, and Harry has plenty of speed.
Well, you know, speed generally beats size every time, so when you have a couple of these Troy players, maybe not big in stature, but they can run around the rink pretty good. It gives you a certain advantage. There's going to be a penalty coming up.
I think it's on Jacob Smith, I think. Kind of looked like it was a good check in the boards. Might have to check the replay. Maybe got an elbow or something.
Looks like Bester going for a head check.
All right, good.
So that's number 13, Nick Bester. Just a terrific skater, mixing it up there a little bit and puts his team down. Jesse to take the draw deep in the Troy end.
Back to that speed thing, Freddie. I always told the kids, you can't hit what you can't catch. So you talk about the size versus speed. Speed will win every time.
Well, now there's going to be a Troy penalty coming up to Royal Oak. Jesse comes screaming down the sideboards, made him a little bit nervous down there, so he had to reach out and grab him. Looks like number 15 for Royal Oak going to the box.
It's Drew Heenan. And again, there's an example where Jesse used his feet, got the puck deep in the zone. Looked like he was going to get by Mr. Heenan. He had to reach out and grab him, take the penalty.
So interference, the call. So we're skating 4-on-4. Back down into the corner. Royal Oak bashing clears it out.
We played a lot of 4-on-4 in the last game, Fred. There was a lot of penalties in that game. I thought that worked to Troy's advantage. We got a lot more scoring opportunities when we were 4-on-4.
Lots of penalties in that game, and the key is to keep your head, to stay out of the box. It doesn't look like much of that's happening, at least early, so maybe we'll settle them down. Thompson throws the puck at the Troy net. Harlech grabs it. Faceoff will be just to his left inside the Royal Oak zone.
Well, you know, the key is keeping your head, Fred. Like you said, you don't want to take too many penalties. You don't get the flow of running all four lines. You know, the penalty killers get tired. It's not the way you want to play.
Troy's going to have just a few seconds of a power play at the tail end of this 4-on-4. Ramon Camo is out there, and I'll tell you, Bill, when it comes to a hockey player with great hands, Camo comes right from that mold. He's terrific to watch.
Ramon is a strong skater. He has delicate hands, and he shoots the puck very well. Everything you want in a hockey player right there.
And a good positive attitude, and the thing is, you talk about hockey skill, Billy, you can't teach hands. It's something that you're born with. God gives it to you, and boy, it's a pleasure to watch it.
Yes, it is. Definitely a pleasure. Ramon played some pretty high-level travel. Michigan Ice Hawks, it was his last team. They're very successful. And another penalty coming up on Royal Oak there.
Penalty coming up. We'll see if two of them are going. Looks like a slash to the Royal Oak player. So the Troy Colts will have a power play. They bring their power play personnel on the ice. Number 16 going for a hold. Billy, what are we looking for in the power play here from the Troy Colts as we start out just to the right of Danny Harlech?
Well, first of all, it's a 4-on-3. You don't see that very often. You have a lot of ice. You don't want to rush anything. You want to make sure you work the puck and get a good, clear shot at the net and, go for any rebound.
Just in the faceoff goes right to Danny Harlech, so they'll do it again.
Yeah, I'm telling you, if Danny sees it, he's going to stop. So we got to get some traffic in there. We got to get him moving side to side. You know, anything but a straight-in shot.
Great glove. Urban, Smitty, throws it at the net. Comes loose. Orlo grabs it softly off the boards, but just out of the reach of Andrew Urban. So we'll go down and try it again.
Nick Fester's just getting ready to step out on the ice. Now it's a 5-on-3.
Uh-oh. But giveaway.
Good back check right there, Fred.
Yeah, key back check because that Royal Oak player was coming fast and furious.
That was Jesse Neathead on the back check, but this guy must have some kind of grease on his jersey because he keeps slipping through.
Yeah, they have kept that puck inside the Troy zone for all of the best efforts. And now here comes Jesse, squirrels around a player back after he lost his stick. And that's that fellow making so much trouble down there in the Troy end, of course, is number 23, Evan Fall, their captain. Bill, one of the cousins out here tonight. We've got lots of brothers on the ice tonight.
Oh,
big hit, and Evan's going for, looks like a penalty. Harlech touches the puck. Billy, tonight on the ice, we have four cousins playing one another. Jesse Neathead on the Troy side, the Fall brothers, Quinn and Evan. Royal Oak plus Clay Kosnick. Family members, and of course, a couple of pairs of brothers on the ice, and lots of kids who came up playing hockey in Troy and Royal Oak.
Definitely, Freddie. Everybody seems to know one another.
Well, here we go inside the zone. He tries to clear the puck, and a big hit, a little high from Evan Fall, so that gets him inside the box 2 minutes for the Royal Oak captain.
So everybody knows one another out here. They played against one another, or they played together. So no secrets out here tonight.
And Mitch just missed a big shot from the blue line. And now it is, winds up inside the Royal Oak net, but that is waved off, net off. Lots of flurry of activity down there, and they'll reset it.
Yeah, 5-on-3 action here. That's what you got to do. You got to get in Danny Harlech's face, make him uncomfortable, bang home a rebound. You know, whatever it takes.
Well, it looks like the faceoff is coming outside the Royal Oak zone, and they are going to line it up. Looks like John Hunter on the ice, along with Harry and Nick Fester. They'll try to slow it down.
Got the senior line out there with Fester. Fester, well, Stu Miller, and Hunter.
Looks like Captain John Hunter, who's circling up. Talk about the Captain John Hunter, showing a lot of leadership, a lot of quiet resolve, but his statistics aren't quiet, Bill. He's ended up on the score sheet a lot of nights.
Johnny Hunter has a booming slap shot. He's a great leader. He actually played on the JV team that they had 2 years ago here. Last year he joined the varsity team, and at the end of the year the players thought so much of him, they made him the captain at the end of last year.
Says a lot about the guy who wears the C on the Troy team. Troy just offside as they couldn't wait, and they'll whistle that one down, so we'll do a line change. They'll line up. Looks like Blake Best and Jesse, Ryan Zoltowski, along with Alex Jakovich and Mitch Thompson on defense.
Still a minute to go on this power play.
Hopefully Jesse wins the draw. Throws it to the corner. Another minute or so.
So hopefully Troy can get settled down and get something going here.
Mitch collects the puck at center ice. He's going driving. He dumps that puck in. Jesse's going to chase that behind the Royal Oak net. Tries to tie him up there. Puck comes loose right around. The Royal Oak player fell down right out into the slot. Zoltowski tries to take a shot. He missed. Mitch throws it towards the net. Jesse picks it up. Back to Jakovich. Throw it at the net.
Oh,
big save. then down low. Jesse wheels it back to Blake. Backed up to half wall. Alex collects it there. Throws it across the ice to Mitch. Mitch tosses it at the net. Oh, and that just missed. Blake took a spill, trying to collect that loose puck. Royal Oak tries to dump it out. Jakovich collects it, throws it at the net.
Oh, nice.
Almost tipped in.
Yeah, got it. Nice low shot, got it tipped. There was a screen in front, just went wide.
Well, you see Blake Best working that down low. Blake Best, a lot of hustle, a lot of strength, a lot of speed. Most of the time you see him really skating fast around the rink, but that time he was like a tree trunk, just standing there waiting to cut something and knock it in.
Well, that's what we've been saying all night long. You got to get traffic in front of Mr. Harlech, and that's what he did.
Fairly evenly matched. Lots of players up and down the ice, everybody getting their run. And the puck is down behind the Royal Oak net. Smitty took a shot to the chops. No call.
But here he comes. Smitty's a great skater, and he scores a lot of key goals for this Troy Colt team.
You want Smitty on the ice, that's for sure. Here comes Jordan Sowerby cutting right in. He centers it. Ramon couldn't quite get the shot. He collects it between his feet. Dumps that back, picked up by the Royal Oak player. Here comes Evan Fall over the red line, over the blue line. A nice dish, he shoots. Oh, and that just missed.
I noticed Royal Oak is going up high on Michael Fisher. I don't know if that's the scouting report, but it's a good thing because a couple times they've shot it over top the net.
Wade Herbert comes to the bench for a change. Wade Herbert, one of my favorite players from the Royal Oak Hockey Association. Oh, and Ramon came cutting right in. He almost got an opportunity stop there.
He tried to dangle, but it didn't quite go all the way through, and he had to turn around and go back for a change.
And that was a key play there by number 18, Mr. Steady, Larry Lawrence Rowe. Always making the good play, Billy, not flashy, consistent, strong, and wise, number 18.
Lawrence, I tell you, he's a sophomore. He made the team last year as a freshman. Only good things ahead of him, I'll tell you that right now.
Well, we're coming over the line. Jakovich knocks it from him. Larry in the corner. He bumped the Royal Oak player, and the puck comes free. Up the right wing. He dumped it in. A couple of players. The door came open. Look out, guys. Got to keep that thing locked.
Oh, they tried to get Lawrence Rowe on the back door. He snuck in off the point. Hopefully somebody... Oh, Bobble's covering for him, so that's good.
Oh, and he made a heck of a play there and knocked that down with his mitt. Royal Oak goes offside. The faceoff just outside the blue line. Of your Troy Colts, Bill, as we go for a player change. Looks like Nick Bester and John Hunter. Here's Stu Miller on the line. So this Coach Zimmerman keeping those changes coming quick.
Yeah, he wants to keep the guys fresh. Don't want to be out there too long, be tired. That's when mistakes happen. Puck ended up in your net.
Troy clears the zone. Puck drives back in. Brendan Fry back after it. He wheels it around to his defensive mate. Back behind the net. Oh, and there's going to be a penalty coming up. Cross check to who?
Looks like it's Andrew Urban going in the box for cross checking. That tells me this guy must have really felt it, because Andrew, he can bring the lumber.
Well, Andrew, a senior player, of course, strong on the blue line, a big hitter in the box from time to time, but sometimes you have to have a little enforcement on your beat, and that's the role of Andrew Urban, number two. Throw it at the net. Doesn't come clear. Another shot from Royal Oak. They're going to try to cycle that puck around, Bill, and they have a pretty decent power play and lots of good puck movement.
Oh, yeah. They have a lot of talent out on that team. Again, Troy wants to stay in their box, keep them to the outside. They're trying to sneak a guy in here for a one-timer. Just missed the pass right there.
And Harry sends that puck all the way down the ice, killing valuable seconds off the clock on this Royal Oak power play. They circle back, trying to get an edge. They break that puck out. Here comes the captain over the red line. Oh, and he's hit from behind. Bester threw a check. He went down and threw the entire operation offside.
Yeah, good back check by Nick Bester. Didn't take the penalty. Didn't quit. Got him to knock them off the stride, and they went offside.
Key to knock guys off the stride on the penalty kill, Bill, but as you know, you don't want to spend a lot of time checking or tying guys up when you're down a man, because then instantly you're almost down two.
Down
two guys.
So
you got to keep it clean.
Exactly. Got to get in and get out really quick.
Royal Oak player cuts it across the ice. Again, a great play by Bester. He clears it, but not out. Kept in by Royal Oak. They cycle it around. And he tipped it there. Wade Herbert drives it back in, but right to the stick.
Smitty fires it down the ice.
Oh, Smitty down the ice with authority. Bester giving chase. Wade Herbert up on the half wall for Royal Oak. He'll get it. Knock it back to his teammate. Bester throws it in offside. They clear it. Gotta love that offside.
Tag up rules best.
Royal Oak picks it up there. Herbert over the line. He's gonna take a shot that's deflected wide. Fisher keeping a keen eye on that puck as it's behind the net. That's one of the things about Fisher and really any goalie. You've got to maintain a visual contact with that puck no matter where it is, even if it is behind your net, Bill.
Concentration is the key for a goalie. You've got to know where everything is. Again, you got to have your head on a swivel, almost like a defenseman. Look over your shoulder. You got to look through bodies, look underneath, in between legs, find that puck wherever it is.
Well, Billy, Royal Oak's trying to find the back door, and they're going to keep trying until they get it. And now we have a face-off here inside the zone. Could have been a hand pass. Not sure what that was, Billy. Did you catch it?
I do not know what that is. They've got the face-off in our zone, so... Oh, the net was knocked off.
Net off, so it's Smitty and Mitch, Jesse, Blake. They'll take the ice. Try to clear out the remainder of this penalty to Andrew Urban. 3 seconds left. Puck clears. Blake Best after it. Urban retreats to the bench.
Yeah, he wanted to go, but he heard the call from the coach, and he thought better of it.
Ryan Zoltowski right off the bench. He almost intercepted the pass and took it to the house. Royal Oak back in the blue line. Through center ice to the neutral zone. Mitch gave a guy a wallop. Of course, number 5, Big Mitch Thompson.
Yeah, it looks like he's going, too. Calling him for an elbow.
An elbow to Mitch Thompson. Guys, got to stay out of the box. This is what kind of impedes your opportunity to put pucks in the net is going shorthanded. I don't know about that one. I guess it was a judgment call, and their judgment was 2 minutes for elbow to the big guy.
Yeah, they said he got him in the head, too, Fred. It looked pretty clean, but... Can't argue with the referee. I haven't ever seen one of them change their mind.
No, that's true. And, of course, they are pledged to keep this game as safe as they possibly can. So we can see the arms and elbows coming up. They want to send a message that they're looking for a clean game tonight.
Any contact to the head is going to be called. And they got the backdoor play right there.
Well, they've been trying to work that play all night, the entire first period, as we look at the clock. 2 minutes and 9 seconds left to go when the first Royal Oak does successfully burn one in the backdoor on the power play. The key, though, Bill, is consecutive penalties from the Troy Colts. You got to stay out of the box. You see this, Billy, as they are on the power play with just a few seconds here.
Well, they work it down low, then they throw it across to the front of the net, and he just slams it in the empty net.
Well, that's tic-tac-toe, and when you're down by a man, it's a little bit easier to free a guy up. Troy's been doing a great job all night, but you can't keep that up for 3 periods. No. You got to keep your guys out of the box.
And that's been the theme here the last 2.5, 3 games, is way too many penalties Troy's been taking, and we got to get that corrected, and it's got to start right about now.
Discipline. Puck didn't come out, and now he gets it over the line. Takes that puck. Oh, he came all the way through. Oh, and he got an opportunity to put the puck in the net. Sowerby clears it in front. Ramon circling, throws it out in front. Oh, a centering pass didn't get through. Jakovich throws it to the corner. Ramon wheels it back around. Sowerby after it. Royal Oak collects it there. Took a favorable bounce, but the Royal Oak player fell down.
Well, after that goal, Troy's had a good push offensively, but Royal Oak has withstood it, and now they're starting a push of their own.
Well, one of the themes that begins to emerge here is penalties, power plays, and man having the man advantage, and you've got to play an even game where you're going to find yourself on the bottom half of the scoreboard.
Well, I'll tell you what right now. One of the strengths of this Troy team is their depth. But once you take penalties, you know, certain guys kill penalties, certain guys go out on the power play. So the depth is eliminated. You don't get everybody on the ice like you should. So we got to stay out of the box.
And I'm sure that's going to be one of the messages from Coach Zimmerman with 50 seconds left here in the first period. The faceoff outside the blue line, the Troy zone. Thompson back on the ice. He threads one through almost to Howard. Keeps it in. Jake circles. Helmet came off, which is unfortunate because it looked like Jake Howard, number 8, was going to get a heck of an opportunity circling in with the puck on his stick.
And that young man right there, he's chewing on his mouth guard like it's a fish hook, and that's not the way you want to wear it, Fred. They put those on for concussions to prevent them, and you don't have it in the right way, you're just looking for trouble.
Well, that's number 16, Griffin Kernan, one of those guys familiar to all of us who came up through the Royal Oak system.
He's an old Royal Oak guy.
His dad, Bill, I saw his grandmother, Pat, walking through the lobby tonight before tonight's game. Lots of hockey families here at the Troy Sports Center tonight.
And you know what? Games like this, they're that much more fun because you get to see a lot of people that you haven't seen in years. You played with them back when the kids were younger, and they've kind of gone their separate ways. And now in the high school game, you come back and see everybody.
Well, here comes this power play opportunity coming up as 2 minutes for boarding.
Boarding.
Not sure who it is. No one's made their way to the box yet. And finally he does.
Got him from behind. They hit Andrew Peters from behind.
Looks like 16 seconds left in the first period. So Troy will have an opportunity for a power play to begin the second period and the remaining seconds here in the first. Camden Sobolewski, 2 minutes for boarding. Nick Bester takes a shot. That falls right in front of Danny Harlick.
Never made it through, got blocked. It's laying right there, but no white jersey there to knock it in.
5 seconds left. Puck comes to center ice. Knocked back in, right on goal. And that'll do it. That's the end of the first period with the Royal Oak High School Ravens 1, Troy Colts 0. And we'll see you for the start of the second period.
For a while, and you get to know a few things. Like, I know she's actually not a morning person. I know she does strange tricks for no treats. I know that water makes her howl like crazy. I even know how the floor stays so clean. She's quick. But the one thing I will never for the life of me know is how she gets so tiny and inside that box. Natalie, how do you get so tiny?
As the teams make their way back out onto the ice, Coach Zimmerman and his Troy High School Colts, Coach Craig Ward and his Royal Oak High School Ravens for the start of the second period. Fred Nahat alongside Bill Jakovich and Billy, hard-fought first period, lots of penalties, lots of power plays, lots of penalty kills. The result, a 1-0 lead for the Royal Oak High School Ravens. Troy definitely has to stay out of the box.
Definitely have to stay out of the box, Freddie. The only goal of the period was a power play goal by Royal Oak's Griffin Kernan, giving them a 1-0 lead. But Troy starts this period on a power play of their own.
Nick Bester, John Hunter, Harry Stumiller up front, Smitty and Thompson on the blue line. Puck is dropped to center ice. Troy takes the puck over the line. Drops it back. Harry to the corner. Royal Oak grabs it. And Aaron mounts Billy, and it goes the length of the ice.
Well, I'll tell you what. The whole first period, Troy had not able to get any sustained pressure in the Royal Oak zone. So hopefully we can get that going here in the second.
Another miscue. Royal Oak takes the puck. Falls loose. Good pass. Captain Evan Fall takes the puck. Over. Attempts to work his way through. Now there's an opportunity for Royal Oak or Troy to clear the puck. Bester, center ice, feeds it through. Harry, down behind the net, maintains control. He lost it there. Royal Oak shovels it around the boards. Kept in by Smitty. Smitty takes it down low. He maintains possession. To Bester. To Mitch. He throws it back. That missed him. Hunter gives chase.
It just seems like Troy's a little bit off on their passes, on their positioning. Just not clicking right now.
Well, we're looking for them to start to click here. A couple minutes left in the period. Jesse grabs the puck, collects it, takes it over the line, drops it back to Smitty. Smitty sends it, not through. Jesse tries to get it back to him. He does. Smitty keeps it in at the line. He took a bump there from the Royal Oak player. Still creased in front of the Troy bench. Bester maintains control, sends it to the corner. Jesse to Smitty. Smitty tries to work it through. Back to the corner. Jesse circles, holds. Back to Smitty. Smitty's going to wind up and take a shot. That got blocked.
Got blocked out high, too, Fred. Never got anywhere close to the goal.
Back down to the corner. Smitty tries to keep it in. Maintains possession. Still in front of the Troy bench. Jesse took a hit and he fell down. Puck finally looks like it goes offside. A little rough and tumble action there in front of the bench. Billy, these guys got to stay out of the box. That penalty expired without any damage being done by the Troy Colts power play, but they got to maintain their focus as they face off just outside the Royal Oak Blue Line.
Well, you could see right there as the battle right before this whistle happened that every inch of ice is going to be contested tonight, and we're just going to have to fight through that legally, not getting any penalties.
Here comes the two-on-two. Zlotowski over the blue line. He sends it into the corner. Jesse tries to collect it. He does. He took a bump, feeds it back to Ryan, it looks like. He sends it back out, tries to get a shot. He can't. Alex throws the puck at the net. Blake Best gives chase. No icing, so he'll play it there. Jesse feeds it through. Across the neutral zone, nobody there. Blake Best gives chase. Position is important, Bill. Staying, maintaining your wing is key to the breakout. And
yeah,
done it here.
Evident right there. We stayed in our lanes. We broke the puck out very easily. Got a chance down here at the end. Hopefully we can find an open guy in front and bang it home.
It's an opportunity. Andrew Urban keeps it in. Blake Best shoots it on the net. When it comes loose, Royal Oak sends it out. Hits the stick of Brendan Fry, so there's no icing.
No icing. We got new troops on the ice. Broke it out. Jordan Sowerby is going to try to get it deep here.
He lost it. Andrew Urban knocks it back to the neutral zone. He uses that big body to muscle it through, and he takes a shot right to Danny Harlick, and a big save through a screen, Billy. That could have been dangerous. Didn't quite get through that time.
No, it didn't get through, Fred, but it was a good shot. Andrew Urban's so strong. I talked to his parents. He worked out religiously over the summer, and he put on a lot of extra muscle here for this hockey season, his senior season.
Faceoff goes behind the Royal Oak net. They try a fly play. Smitty's not buying it.
Good hit by Pierce Baker right there.
Pierce sends the puck back. Another big hit by Smitty. Ramon tries to bring it through. Play ultimately offside. Little bump in there in front of the Royal Oak bench. And as you mentioned, Billy, these guys in white or blue, they're not giving an inch.
No, every piece of ice is contested out there. Nothing free. You're going to have to work for whatever you get tonight.
Bob Urban over the faceoff circle. He wins the draw. Gets it back to Mitch. Mitch dumps it to the neutral zone. Couldn't find a handle on it. Back to Mitch. Feeds a pass through to Howard. Howard dumps it up. That won't go in. Howard throws in on the delayed offside. He bumps the Royal Oak player. Back to Smitty. He feeds it through. Errant bounce. Back to Royal Oak. Herbert over the line. He sent one through. Not there. Royal Oak scores. Really, that's the old production line play. Wade Herbert took that puck, sent it to the corner, got a favorable bounce off the boards, and it's in the back of the net.
Yeah, Smitty had Evan fall out in front. Their skates collided. Smitty went down. That left Evan fall out front to bang that one home.
So the score, 2-0 in favor of the Royal Oak High School Ravens. As we look at this one back, you see Wade Herbert over the line. He throws the puck in.
Oh, actually, it never made it to Evan Paul. It came in from the corner, hit Michael Fisher's pad.
Well, when you talk about breaks, there's good ones and bad ones. Definitely a bad one for Troy on that play, a good one for Royal Oak, and we're 2-0.
And Troy's got to pick it up. They are getting beaten to every loose puck. Their passes aren't crisp. And they haven't had one this period yet, but they have taken way too many penalties early on in this game.
Not playing their game. No. Net to net. Larry Rowe pinches in. Harry picks it up there. He circles in front. John Hunter after it. Comes out to Jakovich. He shoots. Right on net, steered to the corner by Danny Harlech.
No traffic in front of Mr. Harlech. Like I said, if he sees it, he's going to stop it.
Roloke attempts to dump it out. They get it to the neutral zone. And it's back to Lawrence Rowe. He feeds it. John Hunter, he dumps it in. Going to dump and chase and go for a player change. Here comes Jesse and Andrew Irvin along with Zoltowski and the speedy Blake Best. Billy, Blake Best, number six, a sophomore, heck of a hockey player, good hockey family, one speed, always on fast.
Yeah, Blake Best, you look up the word work in the dictionary, and you're going to see Blake Best's picture there. He's always working on the ice. Whether it's on the offensive zone or defensive zone, he is given 100% effort every time.
They continue to work. Jesse feeds the puck around. Back to Jesse. He maintains control, takes it over the red line. Looking to get it into the Royal Oak zone. He does. Skates all the way through, and he was tripped, but no call.
Yeah, the defenseman kind of parted there like the Red Sea, and then at the last second they reached in and pulled him down.
It's going to be a penalty coming up.
Well, they got a hook there, so high stick, actually.
Looks like a high stick, and here is an opportunity for Troy to go on the power play and get back within one. But as you say, Billy, they got to get disciplined. They got to get the passes crisp and continue that successful strategy of moving that puck around. Puck movement on the power play is key. We saw it on the Royal Oak goal, and now we'll try to return this one in kind as we go to the power play at 10:44.
Yeah, you want to move the puck around, but you don't want to rush anything. You want to take your time, set it up, find an open guy, and get a good clean shot. There's a good example right there. We just tipped it wide.
Ramon throws it to Smitty. He throws it on the ice. Pierce Baker behind the net. Ramon comes out with it. He handles the puck, trying to look for a pass. It comes off the skates of Andrew Urban. He gives chase. Wade Herbert made a nice pass, but offside, the captain, Evan Fall.
He tried to delay. Freddie did everything he could, but he went over the line before the puck did, and therefore he was offside.
He's got some speed, that Fall, and some pluck, and you know, he kind of reminds me of the old Montreal Canadiens, Yvan Cornoyer, maybe Yvan Fall, just for tonight.
The flying Frenchman?
Could be.
All right, we'll go with it.
Royal Oak takes the puck from center ice. They drive it right in on Michael Fisher. He's going to cover it up there as Quinn Fall skates in front of Fisher, gives him a little snow job, and they'll take it just to the left of the Troy goaltender.
And again, Troy continues not having sustained pressure in Royal Oak's end. They get a shot, an opportunity, but then it's down the ice.
Well, I'm looking for number eight, Big Jake Howard, to finish something here. Natural goal scorer, great hockey player, good effort, nose for the puck. He's up here high on the left wing, and if we can work it down low, you know Jake's always looking to put it in the back of the net.
Jake is playing very well, both ends of the ice for Troy. He's a strong skater, and if you are not paying attention as a goalie, he will put one under the bar on you.
Well, you know, he'll put you to sleep, too. He has that sort of plodding skating style, that big body. He's grown about 6 inches in the last year, and he's just about caught up with his physical abilities, but his shot's always been there. So you're right. Whenever you can get Howie alone against the goaltender, I'll bet on Howie.
Yeah, I'll take that bet, too, any day. And again, we're struggling right now just to get the puck out of our zone on the power play. I mean, Royal Oak is doing a great job of killing this thing. We try a long pass. We have to tip it. It doesn't connect. Maybe we can get something going here.
Drives it around, keeps it on the half ball. Half wall, Royal Oak keeping the puck. That hit a Royal Oak player, didn't come out. Drives it back into the corner right in front of the Troy bench now. Bob Urban patrolling the area. 14 seconds left in the Royal Oak penalty. Comes out center ice. Back to Smitty, who picks it up with the glove and feeds it to Harry. Harry circles using that speed. Here he comes. He's cutting right in. Harry shoots. Oh, and a big save by Danny Harlick.
Problem with that rush right there, Fred. It was just Harry Stumiller by himself. We did not complete the change, so the other guys were going to the bench. And Harry was already in, so there was nobody there to pick up a rebound.
Pick from Harry there in front of the Troy bench. One thing good about that change, though, Billy, is they were inside their zone, and they didn't go offside. So there was some focus there. We just didn't quite get another player to the net.
No.
Bester throws one at the net. Harlick knocks it down with his big blocker down in the corner. Bester collects it all by himself. He's got some time. Centers the puck. Nothing there. Trying to work it through. Smitty down to the corner. Bester out front. Hunter in his skates. Bester comes through. Wheels it loose. Smitty throws it at the net. Rebound comes out. Gives chase. Back around the corner. Royal Oak picks it up. Smitty pinches in. Oh, and he stole it. Now he goes flying across the ice. Comes John Hunter with a shot that went wide. Harry collects the puck. He dishes. Nick Bester throws it at the net with a high kick, and it is safely inside the glove of Danny Harlick.
Yeah, first time that we've had sustained pressure in Royal Oak zone. We cycled the puck really well. We didn't have a particularly great scoring chance. Threw a couple at Mr. Harlick, and then we threw one high that all he had to do was glove and hold on, and now he can get a change for his team.
The faceoff just to the left of Danny Harlick. Jesse and Blake Zoltowski and Andrew Urban lining up on this side. Mitch on the far side at the point. Digs in. Jesse wins the draw. Goes to Ryan. Feeds it through. Threw it at the net. Blake Best couldn't get one there. Andrew Urban pinches in. Andrew's still after him. Blake comes out with it. Strong on his skates, but Royal Oak picks it up.
Looks like they're going to ice the puck here. Get another face-off in the Royal Oak zone. Hopefully we can win the draw, gain control, and work some plays.
Billy, during that last sequence, number 20, Smitty, one of the things he does so well is pinch. Now, pinch is a timing skill. And if you wait too long, you're going to miss. So it's almost like you have to anticipate where that puck's going. Smitty, great anticipation skills.
Great anticipation skills. And you know what? He is a tall young man. He has a great reach. So, you know, he can chip the puck past those guys when he pinches in, step around him, pick it up, and then cycle it down low.
Mitch keeps the puck in. Now comes Royal Oak. Quinn Fall drives it down the ice. He finds his brother Evan Fall on the other end with it. Andrew Urban fights him off the puck. Big, strong Andrew Urban. Here comes Jesse. Throws it off the board. Great pass.
Yeah, great
here pass. He comes. Ryan Zoltowski in on the net. He shoots. Rebound. Oh, and the net is off.
Best opportunity of the night right there, Fred. It started in our zone. A great pass by number three, Jesse Nahad. He just banked the puck off the boards. Ryan Zoltowski picks it up at center ice, goes in. He had a two-on-one. I'm not sure if he knew he had the two-on-one or not. He threw a puck at the net. There was a rebound. We crashed the net. Here's the replay right here. Here he comes. He takes the shot. Used the defenseman as a screen. The rebound comes in. Blake Best working like always. Just didn't go in. But we're starting to get some chances. Maybe the momentum's coming back on our side.
Well, we'll look to get that momentum shift as the puck comes across to Lawrence Rowe. He circles back, looking to make the right move. He eludes the Royal Oak player, gives a pass up to Ramon. That flies off his stick and is sent back into the Royal Oak zone. A little too early to start dumping and chasing for Royal Oak, so if they're going to start playing that game, they may pay for it. Here comes Pierce over the line. He sends one at the net. Back to Jakovic. Jakovic, he'll load, sends it down into the corner. Sowerby tried to make a move there, didn't come through. Puck comes out. Lawrence Rowe, again, a smart move. Not much of a pass from, couldn't find the handle on it. Sends it out in front of the net. There's no Troy Colts there. Royal Oak takes the puck. Again, Billy, they're starting to dump that puck in neutral ice. I'm not sure that's the strategy you want halfway.
Way too early to do that. You know, they have a big bench. I don't know if they use everybody.
Here comes Ramon cutting right in.
Oh, nice play there. Ramon got the goalie moving to his right, shot it back to the left, and luckily he throws that arm out there and makes a great save with the trapper.
Ramon Campbell, the total package, feet, speed,
power.
And hands.
Power.
And definitely power. It almost paid off from there, but the great glove hand of Danny Harlick coming up huge tonight for Royal Oak.
But the good news is we're getting opportunities now.
There's one there, scrum in front of the net. Oh, that almost went through.
Yep, just knocked that one wide. So you got to just keep putting pucks at the net, Fred. I think maybe one of these will go in once that happens. Who knows?
Smitty curls in. He's looking for Howard. He can't find the handle, but Bob
there
Orton,
it is.
He scores. Billy, Jacob just, Smith took the puck around. He found Jake Howard. He sent it out to Bob Urban, number 12, and it's 2-1.
Yeah, you know what? It actually, I think he was passing it to Jake Howard. It hit his stick out front. Right here, you'll see it. There's Smitty behind the net. Throws it, hits Howard's stick, comes right to Bob Urban, and you got the big body of Jake Howard screen, Harlick. Boom, he finds the back of the net. It's 2-1.
So, Howie, big play on that subtle tip pass to Bobo in number 12. Lights the lamp, so it's 2-1. Right from the faceoff, Evan Fall throws it at the net. Michael Fisher collects it, and the faceoff will go just to his right.
Yeah, good save by Michael Fisher there. He, I'll tell you what, this period he has not seen a whole lot of pucks. That you let that one hit him, gets the feel for it, gets back in the game.
Faceoff there goes to the corner. Smitty collects it, throws it up the ice. Nice tip pass. Here comes Ramon. He tried to feed it through to Nick Bester. That went to the Royal Oak player. And now they turn and go.
Looks like Coach Zim has mixed up the lines a little bit here. We got Ramon Camo out between Bester and Hunter this time.
Well, Billy, when you're not getting the chemistry you're looking for on your set line, sometimes you try to mix it up, and that's what he's looking to do.
You do here anything you can.
Here comes a break. Comes down. He shoots. Sends it through. Oh, and that didn't get to Camo, who was camped out to the right of Danny Harlick.
Another 2-on-1 right there, Fred. That's about third one in the last 5 minutes for Troy. That one, the pass just didn't connect.
Wade Herbert with a shot over the line. Fisher steered that away. Another pass. Oh, that didn't get through.
They had Smitty wide open behind the defenseman.
Looks like they're starting to gamble just a little bit, but that play comes into the Royal Oak zone offside, so we'll face off. With a line change, it looks like the line of Jesse and Ryan Zoltowski, Blake Best coming on the ice with Andrew Urban and Brendan Fry. This line's been together all night. We'll see if they can get something going, eh, Billy?
Well, they had a 2-on-1 the last time they were out. Great scoring chance by Ryan Zoltowski. You know, Mr. Best came in, tried to bang the rebound home, and it just didn't go. So maybe this time's a charm.
Jesse wins the draw. The puck comes right out. Harlick was out of the net. There was a great opportunity, but they weren't able to finish. Brendan takes the puck around the net. Michael Fisher. He throws the puck up on the half wall. Here comes a 2-on-2.
You got a Jesse. Late guy, so it's a 3-on-2, Fred.
Here they come. Feeds it to him. He shoots. Oh, and Andrew Urban just missed the net.
Now what do we have? That's off again.
Well, Danny Harlick,
he's an active goalie. I think going side to side, he must have bumped that off the little pegs, though.
When you get into the game and you get that adrenaline rush, and, you know, those nets sometimes come flying off those safety pegs. So we'll reset it. And it looks like Harry and Pierce, Sauer be down low. Jakovic and Lawrence Rowe on the blue line.
Good play by Larry Rowe right there, blowing that up right at the line.
It's Wade Herbert, 1-on-1. Back check, that goes into the corner. Royal Oak takes it there. Jakovic fights him off. Goes to the line, not out.
Oh, good clear by Lawrence Rowe.
Right through the goal mouth. I'll tell you something about that Lawrence Rowe. It's a smart play. Not trying to do anything. Now here comes a break for Troy. Over the line, Pierce goes low. He feeds it back, shoots it. Didn't get much on it. Sauerby, and he comes past Jakovic.
Going to have to use some speed right here, Fred.
Lawrence has got it circling around his net.
Great job by Larry Rowe. Turned on the Jets.
Kid comes to the line, not out.
Oh, big hit by Pierce Baker.
Big hit.
Tell you what, that's another guy I would not want to get hit by. Oh, Harry Stumiller with an excellent opportunity, but Danny Harlick was there.
A big shot, didn't get a whole lot of mustard on it, so the faceoff's going to go looks like to the right of Danny Harlick. Bob Urban, who scored the last goal, he'll take the faceoff. Howard's out there. Puck comes clear right in front of the goal mouth.
Well, definite shift in momentum here. Troy's carried the play ever since they went down 2-0, so hopefully we can keep that going.
With 2 minutes and 45 seconds left in the second period, let's look to tie this thing up before we go to the dressing room for the start of the third. Babo bumps him off the puck there. Jake collects it. Royal Oak player falls down. That's Clay Kosnick. Big shot.
He's going to get it right back.
Smitty. Around the back of the net. Howie has it there. Oh, he sends it through. Smitty's going to take a shot. That went wide. Oh, and Jake Howard is going to go to the box. Looks like a boarding call, inadvertent as it may have been. Royal Oak player fell down. Howard ended up on top of him. And with 2 minutes and 7 seconds left in the second, Jake Howard's going for two.
Rough penalty to take. I know he didn't want to do it. Late in the period here, Troy is just going to have to buckle down, kill this penalty, and go in the period down 2-1.
They got the guys on the ice to do it. 14 Jakovich, Andrew Urban, Ramon's out there along with the captain, John Hunter. Faceoff comes out. John Hunter picks it up and sends it the length of the ice.
Tell you what, Freddie, there's not very many faceoffs Ramon does not win.
Well, as we said, he's very talented with those hands. And for a hockey player, John Hunter takes a shot, goes right to Danny Harlick.
Well, Ramon put a little pressure on the Royal Oak defenseman there. He coughed up the puck, went right to John Hunter. He threw a knuckleball, but Harlick fought it off.
When you're going 5-on-4, that initial forecheck dedicated to the one player, and you got to make sure you stagger that. And Ramon doing a good job on the back check. So it looks like they're playing it right, and Hunter's coming for a change.
And there goes Blake Best on for John Hunter.
Blake trailing him over the line. Royal Oak player slipped it through. Over the stick of Jakovich, down in the corner. Maintains control, looking to cycle. Back up top. Here comes Ramon. Back to the corner. To the edge. Sends it through. Right to the slot. Blake Best sends it out center ice. 1 minute left in this period.
Yeah, they didn't try to work the backdoor play this time. They tried something different and threw the puck at the net and tried to crash.
They're going for a change. Ramon comes off. Jesse comes on. Late change. Puck goes to the corner. Oh, and they almost got that bank play again,
yeah.
Billy.
It's
a production line.
It's almost like the boards are like the same ones that Joe Lewis with the rebounds they're giving up.
Lindsay and Abel and Howe down there for Royal Oak tonight, playing that bank pass. He sends it to the net, 27 seconds left. Royal Oak still has the puck. Sends it out in the slot. Jakovich takes the puck. Sends it down the length of the ice. Jesse's going to forecheck hard.
Problem, didn't get deep enough. We couldn't get a defensive change there. These guys have been out for the whole 2 minutes.
Right, Jesse caught up with him. Now Hunter almost fed it through. Hits the referee. Jesse had his stick held, but he manages to send it down to Danny Harlick. And the buzzer sounds at the end of the second period. Royal Oak High School Ravens 2, Troy Colts 1. They'll attempt to make a comeback, and we'll see you back here for the start of the third period. Well, the Royal Oak High School Ravens gathering around their benches. We await the arrival of the Troy High School Colts for the start of this third period here at the Troy Sports Center for Michigan High School. Fred Nahat alongside my partner, Bill Jakovich. And Billy, what do you surmise Coach Zimmerman said to his Troy Colts between the second and third to get them fired up?
Well, I think what he said, Fred, is that second half of the period, we kind of dominated. That's what we need for the whole third period. Forget about the first period and the first half of the second period because we took way too many penalties. We were standing around watching, not moving our feet. So let's do what we did when we scored the goal. We worked hard, cycled the puck, found the guy in front of that, caused some traffic, created havoc for Mr. Harlick, and we were rewarded for it.
Well, you know, you got to be deliberate in this game. And if you can be deliberate on faceoffs, on the blue line, through the neutral zone, and that results in puck control and good puck movement. That's a hallmark of a good team. A lot of that comes with confidence. Sometimes a team will get a couple goals on you quick. You lose that confidence a little bit, but you have to draw within yourselves, and I'm sure Coach Zimmerman was trying to draw out, especially his senior leadership. I think about Harry and Jordan Sowerby, John Hunter, guys who are going to go out and lead by example.
Nick Bester is another one of those guys. Got to lead on your seniors. They've been there. They've been through the fire. They know what it takes to win these games, and that's what we're going to, strive for here in the third.
Here we go, the start of the third period. Royal Oak from the faceoff sends it the length of the ice, icing the call, so we'll line up just to the left of Danny Harlick, who's played a heck of a game tonight, Billy.
Definitely, Fred. He's a quality goaltender. He'll make the first save. He might even make the second save, so Troy is going to have to make him work to allow a goal.
Switch it up now to the right side of Danny Harlick. Bob Urban takes the draw. Jake Howard in the slot. He gets it through. Intercepted by the Royal Oak player. Bobo keeps contained. Rolls into the corner. He still has it. Feeds it back out to Mitch. Mitch one times it at the puck. That hit a skate. Howard pokes at the puck and goes back center ice. Smitty throws it in. They'll go back and try it again.
Troy tagged up, and now they're going to try the forecheck.
Howard throws it, Mitch throws it across the neutral zone, intercepted by the Royal Oak player. They're trying to set something up. They'll drive the puck in offside. They clear the zone. Tag up. Here comes Jake Howard over the blue line. Howie low. He shoots one at the net. That rebound comes out. And once again, the Royal Oak player runs into the net and knocks it off its moorings.
Well, Freddie, in between periods, I was up in the stands. There are a lot of interesting spectators here tonight. A lot of the Troy Athens players are here, and the reason that is Troy is Athens is 1 point ahead of the Colts for first place in the OAA White Division, but they've played two more games.
So they got a couple of games in hand, do the Troy Colts, so they have an opportunity, especially now with 16-12 left in this third period. 2-1, the Royal Oak Ravens with the lead, but Troy looking to make a push. That puck goes to the far side. Andrew Urban throws it deep. Sowerby's going to give chase. We'd like to get him untracked. He took a run at the Royal Oak player. He falls down, still being held in. Jordan still chasing the puck. Comes loose, right out in front. And the Royal Oak player, and they'll rush out through the neutral zone.
Good coverage in front of that by the Royal Oak team. They did not let anybody out all by themselves. We tried to center it. They broke it up and came out the other way.
Wade Herbert looks like. Nope, number four throws it into the Royal Oak bench. That stops the play, so the faceoff will be just outside the blue line, or all the way down into the Royal Oak end. Looks like just to the left of Danny Harlick. Ramon to take the faceoff out there with Bester, Hunter, Jakovich, and Lawrence Rowe. He wins the draw. Can't get it through, but Jakovich keeps it at the line.
They're going to call that a hand pass, I believe, Fred.
Well, that's a hand pass of the inadvertent variety. Yeah. Came up in Alex's chest. Not much you could do about that.
Yeah.
All the way, faceoff goes all the way down to the Troy zone.
That's the unfortunate thing there. The faceoff was in Royal Oak zone. An unintentional hand pass, and it's now faceoff in the Troy zone.
Ramon digs in. Setting players, drops the puck, he wins the draw. Lawrence, behind his own net, he reverses field and comes out with it. Drops up the half wall to John Hunter, he can't get it out. The captain's still fighting for it. Puck comes back. Oh, and it's intercepted there. Play goes back in offside.
Got a break right there. That puck just came over the line. That didn't come over the line. That's what they call a blue line turnover. You never want to turn the puck over at your own blue line or the other blue line. Very bad things. All the momentum's going out of the zone. You turn it over, they're coming in the zone uncontested.
Puck back behind Michael Fisher. Collected there up on the half wall. Trying to get a break. They do. Ramon sends it across the ice to John Hunter. He picks it up. Goes in offside. So they're getting some passes across the neutral ice. That's a good sign. They'll go for a player change. Looks like Ryan Zoltowski comes with Jesse and Blake, and they'll set it up along with Smitty and Mitch Thompson.
Yeah, this period's not starting the way Troy wants it to. There's very little flow, a lot of whistles. That's playing into the hands of the Royal Oak team.
Well, there's going to be a penalty, and I'm not so sure about that one. It looks like he fell down after a body check. A lot of us call that hockey, but they're going to call it 2 minutes to Mitch Thompson.
Mr. Thompson threw out his hip and maybe a little bit of the leg. I don't think he connected, but I think they're going to give him one for intent right there.
Well, that's the way it's going to be. They don't change their mind, so they got the PK going. Faceoff comes. They send the puck through. That doesn't reach the net. Quinn Fall drives it deep around the net. Andrew Urban takes it, sends it out to the neutral zone. Intercepted by Evan Fall. He gets the puck back in. On the stick. Oh, toe drag. There he goes. Oh, and he got a great shot.
And he runs into the goalie. Call on that.
Well, I think the resulting call is going to be a faceoff outside the Troy zone, which is a good break for Troy. But no penalty on the play, Billy.
Yeah, if this was the NHL, it might have been different. But this is not quite the NHL.
Jesse and Blake, Smitty and Andrew Urban. Puck off the stick of the Royal Oak player. Goes behind the net. Fighting for it. Trying to stay in the box. Royal Oak down low. Cycles. Circles. Trying to get it to their captain. Smitty ties it up there. Seconds tick away. Puck comes out. Big hit. In the slot. Don't know where it is. Jesse couldn't get the handle on it. Hand pass. Puck's going to go all the way down to the Royal Oak zone. That's a break for Troy.
Yeah, really? Great job by Jacob Smith, ragging the puck in the corner, fighting off two Royal Oak guys. They couldn't get control of the puck, killing valuable seconds off that penalty.
A great play by Andrew Urban, number 12 Bob Urban on the ice tonight. A little opportunity now to talk about the great service of Patty Urban, who does so much for this hockey team. Boy, wouldn't run without Patty. She is in charge of this operation and keeps it running smoothly. We're all grateful to Patty for her service.
I'll tell you what, Freddie, the most thankless job in any youth sport is the team manager, Patty Urban. I mean, it's not just finances. She's working on schedules. She's working on coordinating the parents with their jobs that they have to do for the home games. She's doing the team dinners, and she's talking to the new players on the team, trying to get them acclimated to the team. Just the list goes on, and nobody does it better than Miss Patty Urban.
Absolutely. Our hats off and thanks to Patty Urban for helping the Troy Colts be all they can be. Down in the zone, puck comes around the corner. Evan Fall dishes it. Matthew Bashy has the puck. He sends it, and he scores. It looks like they're going to wave that one off,
are
Billy.
They waving it off? It looks like there might have been contact in front of the net. I don't know. Maybe I see the goalie was down and a defenseman is down in front of the net. So we're going to see what they say.
Well, it was a heck of a shot.
Ready? We got a replay right there. Oh, shot came from the point. There was a couple blue jerseys down there. White jersey and the goalie were all on the ground. So no goal.
Well, they're going to talk it over, but the result is no goals. A heck of a shot by 25, Matthew Bashy. The score remains 2-1. Referee giving his explanation.
All right, the referee just said no goal. There was contact with the goalie prior to the shot. So faceoff comes outside. They're still on the power play for the 25 seconds, but luckily the goal is waved off.
About a half minute left in the penalty to Mitch Thompson. They'll line it up. They're still talking about it. Referee's coming over. Troy players on the ice. John Hunter making his way over to his own bench. Now he circles back. They'll reset it. It's like Ramon. Takes the draw, dishes up in the neutral zone. 20 seconds left in the Royal Oak power play. Hunter intercepts the pass. He's going to come right in. He shoots. That went just wide. Comes flying out. And he fell down, missing that opportunity.
We had Harlech going the other way. The puck came out the other side, but John Hunter just couldn't get to it in time.
And Ramon denies him to the neutral zone. John Hunter puts a hit into Clay Kosnick here on the right along the scorer's table. It looked to me that 21 Clay Kozmic.
Fester's away.
Tripped him right there in his tracks. Clay Kozmic got away with one right there.
They had Nick Fester coming off the bench for the penalty and just threw the puck a little bit too far out in front of him.
Hunter continues to bother him. He fell down. Smitty takes the puck behind his own net. He wheels it around. Nick Fester, he plays with it, tries to get it out. He does. Up to Hunter, another break over the red line. He'll take the puck and dump it in and go for a change. Another key change, Billy, that's important. Keep fresh legs.
Got to keep them fresh. Like I said, when you're tired, that's when mistakes happen. So keep them fresh.
Well, Alex Jakovic didn't make a mistake there. He saw that scout coming around the red line. He kept an eye on him. He pushed that puck back up in the neutral zone for Troy. Now he takes the puck, wheels it down the ice. That is going to be an icing call. Faceoff come back in.
That pass was way too high. It results in an icing faceoff down in our zone. It's about time for Troy to flip the switch and get some momentum going on their side. You know, we're running out of clock. There's just 12 minutes. And you know what I just heard, Freddie? I hear the bugle of Mr. George Baker trying to fire up the crowd for the Troy Colts.
Firing up the Troy faithful, and they're looking like they're doing it. A foot race for the puck. Here comes Harry with that speed. Just can't quite push it through. And it goes back to the neutral zone. Pierce Baker bothers him there. Royal Oak player goes down. Brendan Fry behind his own net. He comes out with it. He's tripped. There's going to be a penalty coming up to Royal Oak. And we'll take that opportunity, Bill. How key is this? And what do you look for on this power play with 11:32 left in the third period? We're looking to tie it up.
Well, we're always looking for an opportunity for Troy to get back into this game. And power play is an awesome opportunity right there. They pulled down our guy behind the net. So I'm going to look for aggressiveness on the puck. Outwork the other team. That's the one misconception people have, that you don't have to work as hard on the power play as the team with the penalty. Oh, there's another one. Check from behind. We're going to have a 5-on-3 here for Troy.
We sure are. Jesse won the draw. Blake came over to the boards to try to get that puck, and he was boarded from behind by the Royal Oak player. And this is a great opportunity as number 16 from Royal Oak goes to the box, leaving them two down. Griffin Kernan in the box along with Kevin Trumbull. It'll be 5-on-3, Bill, in favor of Troy. What are you looking for here as Troy goes on two-man advantage power play?
Well, like I was saying, you still have to work hard when you have the power play. I mean, the team that has the penalty, it's pretty simple. Keep them to the outside. When they have the puck, all they have to do is ice it. You have to outwork those guys, get to the loose pucks. You got to have patience, find an open guy, especially with 5-on-3.
Ramon circles, looks to pass. Oh, and that came out to the neutral zone, so they'll reset it.
That was a good stick in the passing lane right there by Mr. Paul.
Smitty to Fester. Fester throws it in the corner. Hunter after it. Circles to Andrew Urban. Cross ice to Smitty. Smitty looking back door.
They tried the back door play right there. They just could not connect.
Goes up into the netting. To the left of Danny Harlech off the Royal Oak player. So that faceoff will come deep in the zone. Ramon will take the draw. 5-on-3, goes to the Royal Oak player. They take it, whip it the length of the ice. So we'll try to reset it. Smitty back after it. Fisher stops it for him there. Fester come back, looking for position. Throws it to Nick, off the skate. Gains the zone in the corner. Again, 5-on-3. Throws it back to Smitty. He's going to take a shot. That's blocked.
Now you got a guy on the ice, and now it's essentially 5-on-2.
Feeds it through. Oh, it looks like he had an open net there. Couldn't quite get it. Urban's going to have to be in a race for it.
And he's going to take a penalty there for a slash, I'm pretty sure.
Well, it was an important slash because the Royal Oak player with a burst of speed was going to cut right in.
Here's the replay right there. The puck got by him. We took a bad angle shot. He was going to get to the puck. Andrew Urban comes down with the BC two-hander. And now it's 4-on-3.
Billy, you have two columns on your list, good penalties and bad penalties. Where does that one fall?
That one is a good penalty, but, you know, you hate to take one during a power play, especially a 5-on-3, but he was going to be in, so, yeah, you had to do something there.
You got to take that Howard over the line. Howie cutting right in. He shoots.
Oh, it just
didn't go through. Didn't get the mustard on it in the end. A big save by Danny Howlett. Playing a heck of a game today, but there's still some time left. Oh, and Royal Oak scores.
Now, I'll tell you what, right there, Freddie.
I'm not sure that puck went in at first. I think it hit off the post, came back, hit the leg of Michael Fisher. And we'll take a look, but either way, it's 3-1 with 9:56 left.
Here's the replay right here. Comes in, looks like Fish got it. Hit the far post on him. I think he came back and maybe hit a skate and went in the net.
Well, that was Wade Herbert, number 8. Guy we've all played against and played with. I've coached him on a couple of teams. Always a big hustle player, Wade Herbert.
Yeah, he's one of their guys like a Blake Fester or Jesse Nahad. He's always going.
Speaking of Jesse and Blake, they're out there. He circles just out of reach. Blake Best. I'm not sure Blake is back to his old self after taking that big hit from behind earlier in the period, but they'll reset it.
Well, the mountain just got a little bit higher to climb here, and 9 minutes to go, down by 2 goals. You know, a tough one right there. Actually, 2 of the goals tonight, kind of tough, but you got to fight through that stuff, got to work a little bit harder, and, you know, don't quit.
Jesse wins the draw. Back to Smitty. Remember, Billy, this is a Troy team that put 7 consecutive goals on Royal Oak, came back from a 5-0 deficit, so all is not lost. Smitty threw, he shoots. Oh, and that went wide. Rich Thompson at the blue line. He'll dish it back in, but right to the Royal Oak player. It's going to go the length of the ice. Icing the call as Fisher gets it. And as this game goes on, Royal Oak gaining confidence and gaining speed.
Yeah, you know, that rush there by Jacob Smith is another example of what Royal Oak's doing. They're forcing us wider than we want to go. We're taking some bad angle shots. They're missing the net, wrapping around, coming down into our zone. And that's how they got that last goal. It was the same thing. We missed the net, comes down, and they get to the puck first. So we got to find a way to get to the middle of the ice.
Well, you got to win the battle, and you got to win the race, and the goal that came off of the post.
Great save by Michael Fisher right there.
Yeah, the fall on the wraparound. That goal, the goal that came in off Michael Fisher was really due to a race that was won by the Royal Oak player. They never gave up, and so that's how that ends up in the back of the net. But no, again, 9 minutes left in this game. It's a lot of talented scorers on the Troy hockey team, so we're looking for a comeback.
Anything can happen, Fred.
Pushes it through there. Lawrence gives chase. Royal Oak still maintains, whips it around. Teams at full strength. Royal Oak maintains possession. That puck comes out. Oh, and here comes a break. Pierce almost went through with it. Harry takes it, dumps it down inside the zone. They'll go for a change. Thompson, Camo, Smitty with Stu Miller. Oh, there's that came loose. That was almost a break. And he's offside. Waves it off. Ramon will give it a try. He sends it in. Oh, excuse me. We were down a player. Andrew Irvin back on the ice. Now they're at full strength. Mitch tries to get it through. Big hit. Nothing there.
Oh, submarined him.
Big hit. Oh. That should have been a penalty.
Game got a little chippy all of a sudden, right, Fred?
Sure did. That's what happens.
Yeah.
Ramon, circle, sends it through. Oh,
nice
here's
pass.
A pass.
Oh. Big save.
Danny Howlett collects it. He didn't quite get anything on it. But the opportunities are coming. Still with 7:46 left to go. Jake Howard out on the ice. And this is, it's going to be interesting.
Definitely is, Fred. It's not like Troy's not getting opportunities. Jake Howard had one. Nick Bester had one. Jordan Sowerby just had one right there. Danny Harlick's just been making some good saves, and we've been missing the net when we do get those opportunities.
And with 7 minutes and 46 seconds left in this game, Royal Oak up 3-1. Bob Urban over the faceoff circle. He wins the draw back to Mitch. Mitch fires at the net, and that goes wide. Bob battling for it down low. He took a spill. Howard digs it out. He lost it to the Royal Oak player around the net. He pulls up, tries the other side. He's got some room to move. Howard knocks it back in with that big stick of his. Out in front, Mitch drives it through. Another opportunity for Troy. Bob Urban going in the corner. Good discipline from Bob Urban, not taking a cheap shot. Back to Mitch. Mitch will throw it at the ice.
Good tip. Rebound.
Oh, and that went just wide. Wide open net. Keep throwing the puck at the net, and good things will happen. It almost did there, Billy.
Yeah, this line's been working very well. I don't know if that came out or not. Smitty's got to hold his temper here so he doesn't get one. But he just did.
Well, the puck came out, and maybe more than the penalty, you don't want to treat an expensive piece of hockey equipment like he did with that stick.
Yeah, I know. Those are $150, $200 pieces of, what are they now, fiberglass?
Well, it depends on your preference. Me, I like the old wooden Sherwood, as you know, Billy.
Oh, Mr. Smith is 10-minute misconduct. I think he's gone for the game. That's a big blow for Troy.
A huge loss. Now, the story becomes even more of an uphill battle.
Oh, he gets a 2 unsportsmanlike and a 10-minute misconduct.
Ryan will serve his penalty, number 10, Ryan Zolkowski. As we look at the players out on the ice, 6:57 left to go, 3-1, Royal Oak in the lead.
Well, we're back to the story of the first period where Troy's taken way too many penalties.
Faceoff stays right there in the circle, and then it's shoveled toward Michael Fisher, who covers it up, and they'll do it all over again. Jesse wins the draw in the corner. Alex wheels it around. Matthew Bashing back after it. Harlick stops it there. Jesse is going to beat him there. He got to the puck first. He's going to tie it up. Valuable seconds. Number 3 on the forecheck. Now he cycles out. Blake Best begins to pinch. Blake Best with an opportunity. He's going to throw it at the net. Oh, and that went just wide.
Might as well throw everything at the net now, Brad. We're down 2 goals, 6 minutes to go.
At this point, you're right about that. Another opportunity. A little bit of riverboat gambling coming in from both sides there at the blue line. And as you said, that's no place to gamble.
No, definitely not.
Down in the corner, Blake Best is going to take it out. He's going to drive it the length of the ice. Jesse coming off for a change. Urban coming off. Hunter, Bester, Thompson, and Rowe. The 4 for Troy on this penalty kill. 49 seconds left in the penalty. Shorthanded goal here would be nice. Oh, and a big hit from Mitch Thompson. He's going to feel that tomorrow.
And the referee has his arm up, Fred. I think he made a little contact with the head. So we said it earlier tonight, Fred. Anytime you make contact with the head, these guys are going to put you in the box. And this one referee has made every call that way tonight.
Well, I don't know about every call, Billy. As I look back on some of the plays, as Troy rushes into the Royal Oak zone, I see some plays that look similar in style and in result, but it doesn't seem as though the players in blue are ending up in the penalty box with quite the same amount of frequency. Howard breaks through. Here comes Howie on the line. That's a neat tip and elbow, no call. Royal Oak circles with it. This is when things get chippy, so you better watch out.
Yep. No place for a nervous person out there right now.
Well, you know, you're right about that, Bill, and being a referee is a thankless job.
It's number 2 right behind the team manager.
Well, you're always going to upset somebody with your play calls, but I'll tell you something. Sometimes, while they're trying to get control of the game, they end up increasing the chippiness and the testiness on the ice.
Yeah, there's a frustration level by the players. You know, they don't know what's legal and what's not legal. And, you know, that just leads to, like you said, more chippiness.
4 minutes and 44 seconds left in this game. Royal Oak leading 3-1. They have the power play. Troy takes it, sends it out. Matthew Bashy turns in circles, throws it all the way in. And he waved off the icing, Bill, 25 clearly behind the red line. And with Royal Oak with the power play, I'm not sure why that wasn't an icing.
Yeah, I don't know, Fred. Maybe he just wants to go home tonight. I can't tell you. I'm just out here looking at the defensive pairing. We got a Kevin Jakovic and a Lawrence Rowe, a sophomore and a freshman.
Well, Kevin stood him up at the blue line. Puck comes back in there. KJ circles to Hunter. Hunter's got the puck. He's going to cut right in. He makes a move. He's going to toss it at the net right into the breadbasket of Danny Harlech, and that's a story we've seen over and over and over again here tonight.
Well, there's another prototypical butterfly save right there. You know, the puck's in a certain level. They go down, catch it right in the breadbasket. No rebound. Whistle. Regroup.
3:57 left to go in this one. Royal Oak leads it 3-1. Jesse takes the faceoff. It stays right there. He circles it back to the line. Blake pulls up, looking no worse for the wear. Seems like he's getting stronger as they go. Good to see that, because he took that big hit earlier, Billy. You never like to see anybody get hurt.
No, I don't want anybody get hurt. That was a good faceoff win by Jesse Nahat. They got the puck in the zone.
Andrew Urban. He'll feed it through to Blake. That goes flying up in the air. That was a good pinch by Andrew.
Yep. Full strength now, Mark, for Troy.
3:30 left to go. They're looking to put one in so maybe they can take their chances with an extra attacker in the final minute or so. Goes all the way down. Once again, the referee waves off the icing call.
Freddie, I think you're going to buy that referee dinner after tonight. I don't know. I'm seeing a lot of pinches by all the Troy High defensemen. It's going to lead to chances at both ends. Chances for Troy, and then chances for Royal Oak, as, you know, there's nobody back.
Jesse cut right in, tried to feed it through. Now it's coming back. Lawrence circles with it. He dishes it to Jesse at neutral ice. He can't handle it. Lawrence drives it in. Back onside, Royal Oak collects it, sends it out. Mitch Thompson's going to turn and go with it. Big number five behind his own net. Here comes Sowerby. They crisscross. Mitch handles the puck. He almost lost it there. Feeds it up through the neutral zone. Here comes Lawrence all the way in on a rush. Willow's going to take out and bounce it out to the center ice.
Freddie, that's what happens sometimes during games like this. Everybody tries to do it themselves. You're better off trying to make the pass sometimes, because it's a lot easier for the defensive team to concentrate on one guy than it is all five of them. Oh, there was a slash there. Harrison Stumiller got slashed on the wrist. And I don't think they called it.
They did not call it. There was a little bit of a collision there at the blue line. Little leg-on-leg action. But much as we've seen tonight, the play has gone through for Troy. Now that faceoff ends up just to the left of Michael Fisher.
Well, Freddie, I know in the last few minutes we've been talking about the officiating, but let's not take anything away from this Royal Oak team. They've come in here tonight. They've played their game. They've been fast to the puck. They've passed the puck well. They've buried their chances when they could. And, you know, they've played a really good game.
Well, there's no question about that. Here on the home ice, the Troy Colts. Puck goes back to the line. That's sent through. Royal Oak definitely playing their game. A great hockey team. And I'll tell you something. I think the Troy Colts surprised them last time out on at the John Lindell Arena. And I'm not sure they were taking them very seriously. Something they've definitely done here tonight. Ramon feeds it through.
There it is.
Oh, right to the goal line.
Just post, Fred.
Well, they almost put one through.
That would have made for a great finish right there.
1 minute left in this hockey game as Alex Jakovic sends it into the zone.
Good hold in by Andrew Urban.
Andrew Urban, but he lost it. Goes back to the line. Here's Wade Herbert. He's sick through. Oh, and a big pad save by Michael Fisher.
Great save by Michael Fisher right there. Mr. Herbert dangled the puck, got around Mr. Jakovic, and Mr. Fisher put the pad down and made a great save.
40 seconds left to go in this hockey game. Here comes Bester down into the corner. He feeds it back to Hunter. 30 seconds to go. Oh, and he scores!
Oh, my. Lawrence Rowe with a rocket from just outside the circle. You know what? We're going to have a good finish here with 30 seconds to go.
30 seconds left to go, Billy. What's the strategy from the Troy bench?
The strategy is to get Fish out of the net. I wouldn't be surprised if we call a timeout here. Here's the replay. Off a skate, Lawrence Rowe steps into it and goes in the net.
Just as you said, Coach Zimmerman calls a timeout. And they'll collect their thoughts along the Troy bench. Well, Billy, I don't see a fat lady, and she's not singing. So a half a minute to go. They're going to try to push that puck forward with an extra attacker, I would imagine. How are you drawing it up on your board if you got the chalk?
Well, I'm thinking I got to put Ramon Camo out at center because he might win the draw, or he should win the draw. He's won the majority of his draws tonight. I get it back to my defenseman. We skate it up over the red line, dump it in. And then we just got to bust our butts down there to get it, get control, cycle it, throw something to the front of the net, and who knows, hit a skate, something, bang it in.
Last man in on this replay, Lawrence Rowe just winds up and takes a big slap shot. Ends up in the left-hand corner, just over the outreach glove of Danny Harlan.
Hey, Freddie, I just want to take a minute here and acknowledge our public address announcer, Rob Franchi. His son, Alex, graduated 2 years ago. He was a goalie. Rob was a great PA announcer. Come out of retirement tonight to help us out. He did a great job.
Troy wins a draw. Sends it through all the way to Harlech, and he's going to sit on it. So with 24 seconds left to go in this hockey game, they have what they wanted, Billy. A faceoff deep in the Royal Oak end. Do the X's and O's in this faceoff. How are you going to chalk it?
Well, let's see. What face-off circle are you going to put it to? You want to overload. Looks like they're going to go to the right of Mr. Harlech. So you want to overload the center of the ice. We have an extra guy. Overload that. Put a guy on the boards, a couple guys back. Try to win it. Either push it towards the center of the ice or go back. And then, you know, have somebody bang at it and see what happens.
Well, you got to get the puck back to your shooter and try to get something through. Maybe a deflection, maybe a screen, plenty of time to do it.
Well, you can either get it back to the shooter, or since you have an overload here on the right side, push it that way, and maybe the numbers can win the job for you and create some havoc and get a natural screen right there and bang it in.
Key to this faceoff, if you do have a left-handed center, they can go forward with the puck. And, you know, you try that a couple of times. It generally works once or twice per season. So you may be right. That could be the strategy to go forward rather than reverse it.
And one crazy thought. If you do have the left-handed face-off guy, he could almost shoot it at the net himself right off the drop. I've seen that happen.
It has been known to happen once or twice in a season. So here we'll set it up. Howard, Bester, and John Hunter up front. Andrew Urban in the back.
Ramon is left-handed, and he is taking the draw. So we got two on the right side, one on the board, and two back.
Tail of the extra attacker, and here we go.
Looks like he's going to go forward with it.
He does, goes to the corner, and they'll send it down the length of the ice, just past the net.
And then no icing.
No icing. Not sure why they didn't call icing on that.
Harlech came out to play that puck. There's an empty net if we can get control of it. Well, it's going to end it here. Oh.
And that'll do it. An interesting call to end things on here at the Troy Sports Arena. An extra attacker, 6-on-5. Royal Oak coming up victorious on the other end of the score. 3-2, Royal Oak over your Troy Colts. Billy, not sure what the explanation is for that last sequence.
Yeah,
what,
I don't know.
What are your thoughts?
I think maybe they said we tipped the puck or something like that. That's why they waved off the icing. I'm not exactly sure. But a great effort by the Royal Oak team. They came in here to play tonight. They knew that they let one slip away back in December. So, you know what? That was one of the two games we had on hand in hand against Athens trying to catch them. And we're just going to have to regroup and not let another one slip through our fingers.
Well, the Troy Colts and the Royal Oak High School Ravens, a spirited effort here tonight. Good, clean game. Lots of penalties, mostly of the incidental variety, nothing dirty. lot of these players, as we mentioned, played with one another coming up through Royal Oak and Troy Hockey and other associations here. The four cousins on the ice. Plus, you got the Jakovich brothers, the Urban brothers, the Fall brothers. Nothing but good, clean hockey fun tonight. And the result, Royal Oak Ravens 3, your Troy Colts 2 tonight. For my broadcast partner, Bill Jakovich, and the rest of the crew from the Troy Television Service, I'm Fred Nahat. Hope you enjoyed tonight's game. Good night, everybody.